This creates the same loophole status during Vietnam. The draft unfairly targets young people, minorities, and those in the lower class. With the draft, you create two key unfair problems. First, it forces men and women into a state of slavery. Second, it creates loopholes for the rich to avoid military service. Our second argument is that the draft will empower the executive branch. Right now, our military is not capable of fighting multiple wars effectively, but if there were to be a draft, our Congress would be more willing to throw men into the fray and possibly throw their lives away for nothing. We should not be engaged in military conflicts that are not necessary to our national security. Having fewer troops forces us to make decisions about where to use them. By having a limited number of troops, we are less willing to pursue unnecessary wars. When we make a mistake and our troops become overstretched, we step up in recruiting temporarily, fix the problem, and learn from that mistake. That is the all-volunteer force. With the draft, we have an endless supply of troops. This means that it is easier to start a war. We will potentially lose millions of people's trust, if not everyone's, in the government's role as protectors of our lives, well-being, and our morality. The draft will make any president less accountable to the American people because they will always be able to draft more soldiers. They don't need to ask to increase the size of the military because we draft everyone can serve. We have shown that our all-volunteer force is fair and inclusive, while a draft is nothing more than a tool for discrimination. We have shown that the all-volunteer force prevents unnecessary conflicts.